When looking for horizontal asymptotes in rational functions, the theory says we want to know what's happening to the graph as x gets infinitely big. Well, as x gets infinitely big, it turns out only the largest power terms in the numerator and denominator really matter. So we're going to focus on those terms for our three simple rules. F of x is an example of the first part of the rule. Notice the numerator has degree 0. The denominator has degree 1. Well, whenever the denominator has higher power than the numerator, the horizontal asymptote is going to be located at the horizontal line y equals 0. Because as x gets infinitely big here, we're dividing by a larger and larger number, which makes it closer and closer to 0. G of x is an example of the second part of our rule. Well, what if the top is higher power than the bottom? Notice the top is second degree, the bottom is first degree, so the top is higher power. Well, that means as x gets large, the top is going to be getting significantly larger than the bottom. So the numerator is going to be getting infinitely large, which means that this is not going to approach a whole number. It's going to be heading off towards infinity. Therefore, there is no horizontal asymptote for g of x. Well, those two parts of the rule obviously beg the third part. What if the top and bottom are equal degree? If you take a look, this is second degree in the numerator, this is second degree in the denominator. So what we're going to do is focus in just on those second degree terms, because as x gets infinitely large, those lesser terms, those lower degree terms, become less influential, leaving us with simply x squared over x squared. And if we divide those terms, we find out that the horizontal asymptote is going to be at y equals 1. Here's another case where the numerator and denominator have the same degree. In this case, they're both first degree. So we're going to take a look at those highest power terms, 4x and 2x. And if we divide those terms and divide their lead coefficients, 4 divided by 2 tells us the horizontal asymptote will be at y equals 2. Be careful when identifying the degree of a function and identifying and locating those highest power terms. Sometimes the polynomial on top or bottom may be written out of order, out of traditional order anyway. In this case, both the top and bottom are second degree, and there are our lead terms. So 2x squared and negative 3x squared are the terms we want to focus on, and dividing those lead coefficients tells us that the horizontal asymptote for this function is at y equals negative 2/3. While finding x-intercepts and vertical asymptotes we like factored form, it's actually easier to see what the horizontal asymptote is if something's not in factored form. But if it is, remember we only need to really concern ourselves with the highest powered term. So if we were to multiply this out, the highest power term on top would be a 12x squared. The highest power term on bottom is going to be a 10x squared. So these are going to both be quadratics on top and bottom, meaning this is going to be the third part of our rule where they're equal degree. So we're simply going to divide the lead coefficient on top by the lead coefficient on bottom, telling us that the horizontal asymptote is going to be at y equals 12/10 or 6/5. That's our horizontal asymptote for n of x.